Volvo just figured out how to lower the defense budget without threatening national security.
We'll show you the dramatic chase of bank robbery suspects at 11.
Good. It's mending nicely.
Excuse me. Could I talk to you for a second?
Sure. Something wrong?
Yeah, something's wrong. Did you order that Mrs. K's slides be sterilized?
Yeah. You had them on file for over 3 months. I needed them for another patient.
Colin, those slides were part of a study. I was keeping a file on her.
We have over 300 patients walk through that door every month. You didn't need those slides.
Mrs. K walks through that door 4 times a month, leaving 296 patients, which is why I was doing the study, to find out why she's so chronic.
Triage. At any given moment, you treat the most serious need. We were running short of microscope slides. You didn't need those. I took them for patients who did.
Just because I don't treat these patients like numbers does not mean I'm incompetent.
Hey, are you saying I don't care? I care. I just don't let my emotions get in the way.
And what is that supposed to mean?
Colleen, Kathleen, there are a couple of patients waiting to see you.
I bet you don't see me. Yeah.
Roger, Beth, hi.
Hi.
Is everything all right?
Oh, yeah, everything is fine.
Awesome. What's so funny?
Kathleen, since you were the one who introduced us, we wanted you to be one of the first to know.
You're getting married? Ah! When? Tell me everything.
Well, he asked me last night.
Down on one knee, too, you know.
Congratulations. So when's the big day?
We're still debating that one, Saturday or Sunday.
As in this Saturday or Sunday? Mm-hmm.
Kathleen, my brother's off the island right now, and since you were the one who brought us together, I would like for you to be my best man.
Best man?
True.
And in the interest of symmetry, Colin, I'd like you to be my maid of honor.
Great.
The reviews are in, and this new Toyota is a winner. Automobile Magazine calls it a global success. Motor Trend calls it a car with definite family influences from Camry and Lexus. Detroit Free Press calls it the benchmark. We call it Corolla. Presenting the all-new Toyota Corolla. Discover why, after 25 years, it's still impressing all the right people.
No little cinnamon gum freshens breath longer than Big Red.
So kiss a little longer, hug a little longer, stay close a little longer, longer with Big Red. That Big Red freshness lasts right through it. Your fresh breath goes on and on. While you chew it, say goodbye a little longer. Make it last a little longer. Give your breath long-lasting freshness with Big Red.
You all right, Alex?
Oh, yeah. I thought I had you there at the end.
Well, I've always been a strong finisher.
You gotta get rid of these bad army habits, Ben. Running on the beach, living in tents.
Running in the sand keeps your legs strong.
You ever go to the Natural History Museum when you were a kid?
All the time.
Your camp here reminds me of one of the exhibits. Primitive man. Half-naked woman.
Bunga bunga.
The purpose of that exhibit is to show how men used to live.
Truth is, studying by flashlight does kind of suck.
Well, what were you thinking? Maybe hunting down some roommates, an apartment?
I hadn't thought about it.
Well, there's tons of places on the island.
Well, what are you doing today?
Class till 2. Nothing after that.
Your place, 2:30?
I'll be there. I've got class and I haven't showered.
Me too.
Yeah?
Pardon me, Henry. It can wait till later.
You see that peninsula straight ahead out there?
Yes.
About 20 miles beyond there, there's a group of stray islands. Empty. Virgin. Unexplored.
Yes.
You know, Mikey, I've had a lot of birthdays. 30th, 40th, half century. None of them has fazed me a bit.
I'm sorry, Henry. I was so busy at the clinic. Happy birthday, man.
Ah, hogwash. Now, the point is, this one's got me in a steel grip. Right where it counts.
How old are you?
Same age my father was when his ticker exploded.
But, Henry, people are living a lot longer these days. You're a strong man in good shape.
I'm going sailing, Mikey. Solo. I'm gonna visit one of those deserted islands.
You won't get a little lonely?
Lonely? What the hell has lonely got to do with it?
Old time people then used to say.
So, how do you like it?
It's not Buckingham Palace, but it has great soul, man.
Well, it's got character, I'll give you that.
Thank you, and it'll be an honor to have a doctor living in my home.
Oh, a student, Mr. Shanton, but thanks.
Call me Dominique, man, just Dominique.
No electrical outlets?
Don't worry about that, man. I'll get the extension run from my home to your home.
This is interesting. What is it?
Well, that's not an it, that's a who. My son's idea of job. He's a Rasta man and an incredible musician.
It's interesting that you left open the front wall.
Well, that's my son's idea as well. He likes this openness. He says it brings in the good music and lets out the bad. Ah, so, do you like it?
Well, the room certainly has a life of its own.
Yeah.
And the view's incredible.
Yeah.
But I do think that the lack of running water, the holes in the ceiling, and the missing fourth wall could pose some problems down the line.
Well, the old houses are on the back, and as for this roof, I'll fix it, man. No problem at all.
I can give you a hand with the roof if you like.
Oh, that would be wonderful. A hand is always welcome.
Well, we do have other places to look at. Quite a few, actually. Seems there's a glut on the market these days.
How much for the place, Dominique?
Not much. For you, 100 a week.
Ben, you're not even considering.
I'll take it.
You'll take it. Wonderful.
So, will Beth continue to work at the library when she's married?
I don't know. It's really up to her, you know?
Roger, I need to talk to you about something.
I know you didn't come out here to talk about the blood test for the wedding.
No. It's about Colin. And both of us standing up for you at the wedding. With the way things have been going with us lately, I'm afraid that it might be...
uncomfortable.
Yeah. And I don't want to bring any of that uncomfortableness into your ceremony.
So you're saying you don't want to be my best man?
No, it's not that. I'm honored. I mean, I might never get to be a best man again, you know? But...
Well, then it's settled. You're coming to my wedding as my best man. Don't you know Beth and I have enough love to go around for everybody? Trouble over there.
Oh,
little thing.
What's the trouble, Beanie? Stuck in the fence again, no?
Okay.
Yeah. What's the trouble, Beanie? Right, Beanie? Yeah?
Baby. So, what does a best man do at a gentecan wedding anyway?
Oh, there's not a lot to it, really. You just have to choose a few things. It's really more of a symbolic thing, you know?
Hold the rings, etc.
Etc. Don't worry about a thing, Kathleen. Everything will be all right.
Well, Dad, you finally got me out in the open.
A long time, hasn't it? Over 26 years since we last spoke. A long time. Well, I got news for you. If you squint back about 20 miles, you'll see a medical school. My medical school. Croft University. That's right, I made it. With my own blood and sweat and my own money. And if you were here now to see it, you wouldn't give a rat's ass, would you? So, Dad, I want to thank you for everything. Thank you for beating me down. Thank you for the ridicule, the humiliation. Thank you for hating me so much. I just had to become a success. I couldn't have done it without you, you bastard.
Before you pull it over, slip it on, zip it up, caress to feel softer. Before you button it up, slide it on, wrap it round, caress. It's the first step to feeling beautiful. It's the moisturizing body bar with bath oil. Caress leaves skin softer than soap can. Before you tie it up, clip it on, step on in, or step on out. Before you dress, caress.
I like to dream. Yes, yes, right between the sound machine. On the cloud of sound, I drink in the night.
Filtered Miller Genuine Draft. For those who've discovered its smooth draft taste, the world is a very cool place.
Hey, did you know nothing's easier than Static Guard or brushing away stubborn pet hair? Just spray and brush. Static Guard, the easy way to spray pet hair away.
Paul, you've shoveled the driveway already? Oh, your back's hurting again? You need Motrin IB. Works great for backaches. You take the Motrin, I'll finish the driveway.
Motrin IB, the relief of Motrin in non-prescription strength.
Saturday, a high-class madam names Tony as a client.
Is it true you have a preference for red garter belts?
I'm not one of your clients. You've lost the public's trust.
But I haven't done anything wrong!
Saturday, the commish. Sunday.
Who are you, Neil?
Anybody you want to be.
Cher, Michelle Pfeiffer, Susan Sarandon, and Jack Nicholson.
Uncontrollable appetite.
In the sinfully funny Witches of Eastwick, Sunday at 8:30, 7:30 Central.
Hey, you, I want an answer. You can't laugh at a man's private thoughts and just walk away like that. Mister, I'm talking to you. Hey!
The name is Richard Hanover.
And I'm Dr. Henry Croft.
That's supposed to mean something to me?
Sure. See that island out there, that shantique? That's mine. Or at least part of it is.
Great.
Have you never heard of human decency? What line of work are you in?
Despite the prosperity that you see around you, I'm currently unemployed. I used to fool around with electronics in my parents' garage. Next thing I knew, I was a statistic in the S&P 500. Petrocomp Computers. Heard of it?
You? You're the Richard Hanover? The wunderkind who sold out to IBM?
I figured that would impress a guy like you.
Well, what'd you make in that deal anyway?
Money.
How much?
You reek of it. Rolex watch, polo jacket. Why don't you just slip on the diamond pinky ring? Stop pussyfooting around.
Oh, you're one of those self-loathing millionaires, are you?
That boat that you parked back down at the beach, what'd that run you, 60, 70 grand?
I don't think you know who you're talking to. I'm Dr. Henry Croft. I invented the hip joint replacement system, and I sold the patent for $55 million.
That's all?
All? What the hell's that supposed to mean?
Watch your head.
What do you say? Gee, what the hell's this contraption?
It's a sluice box. It brings fresh rainwater to my camp.
Oh, my God.
Swiss Family Robinson, huh?
How long have you been here?
Well, let's see. The day I left, the Times headline read, Dubaroth scores gold at summer game.
Well, that was 1984. Are you telling me you've been alone on this island for the past 9 years?
So I have. Time flies.
Hey, guys. I need to ask you a favor. You've met Ben Harrison, right?
Kathleen has, up close and personal.
He just got a new place.
What, he got a better beach?
No, real place. Well, sort of. Problem is, he doesn't have a shower. And I was wondering if...
Wondering if what?
Alex is trying to get a favor from us.
What are you saying, Alex? Ben wants to use our shower?
He never said so himself. I was just thinking.
Alex, it's already pretty crowded around here in the morning.
Yeah, and we do always seem to run out of hot water just when I want to take a shower.
Okay, granted. But Ben is a very frugal man. I'm sure he won't use much water. And he can even shower in the off hours. How's that?
All right, it's fine with me, as long as he uses your shower.
Wait a minute. This is a guy who not only crashed a class, crashed the whole school, right?
Precisely. A bold and respectable move. Not to mention he got in.
And you want to give this gate crasher a key to our house? I don't know, Alex.
Just give him a shot, Cheryl.
What are you trying to do, Alex? Fix Cheryl and Ben up on a blind date?
Oh, what about the trip up to Camberley Village tomorrow? We'll take Ben along and he can check out the kids for measles with us.
Fine, he'll come. Just don't expect any miracles.
I broke your camp, Alex. Bags are packed, ready to go when you are.
Hey, Ben.
Hi.
This is Cheryl, Charlie, and I believe you met Kathleen.
Hi.
Yes, I have. How you doing?
Won't you have some of the steak? It's perfectly marble. Look, I chose it myself.
No, thanks. I don't eat mammal flesh anymore.
You know, I've been thinking. 9 years alone on a desert island is enough for any man. I'd like you to come back to Chantique with me.
Why?
Because obviously you're nuts.
Your father, working class man?
Yeah. As a matter of fact, he was a butcher.
So the old man's a butcher, son's a doctor. Somehow that holds a certain irony.
You know, one of my doctors, a cardio man, has a second degree in psychiatry. Might behoove you to meet with him, take a couple of sanity tests.
Might behoove you, too.
Meaning?
You think I'm crazy.
Correct.
All I'm saying is by whose definition?
Care for a little claret?
No, thanks. Back in 69, so many people wanted a piece of me, I stayed drunk or stoned for nearly a year. God, amazing times. Out of nowhere, I had money, women. I was on the cover of 7 magazines simultaneously. I even played guitar with the Grateful Dead a couple of times. It was my favorite rock group. I thought that might do the trick.
The trick? What do you mean, get you on the wagon?
No, not that. To rid myself of it.
Of what?
Fame.
Oh, that devil. Yeah, I had a bout with him myself. Like a roller coaster ride with no safety belt.
All you had to worry about was 55 million. What kept me sane was an old man who used to clean my office. Every night for 4 years, he'd come in and insult my ass. I thought of getting him fired until I found myself staying later and later just so I wouldn't miss him. One day he didn't show.
He died?
Last thing I wanted to do was to go to a funeral, let alone this guy's. But I went. And afterwards, I walked into the woods and I started talking to a tree like it was the old man. You sorry son of a bitch, I said. Why did you have to go and die? So you see, I was talking to trees just like you were.
I was talking to my father.
Who's dead. So who's to say we're not all crazy, huh?
Benny, all your duties as best man and the maid of honor, they're really relatively simple, you know.
Well, except for possibly one thing.
One thing?
Yeah, it has to do with goats.
The goats?
Kathleen, it's always been a tradition in my family for the best man to provide a special soup.
Uh-huh.
We call it goat's head soup.
Well, if you want me as best man to cook up some soup...
No, no, you don't have to make the soup.
Uh-huh.
All you need to do is choose the goat for this soup.
Oh, no.
That's a problem, right?
Oh, no. No problem, Roger. She can handle it.
Speak for yourself. Why can't the maid of honor choose?
That's not the custom, Kathleen. Take a few minutes, if you can. You choose a goat, and we meet you back at the house. Okay?
You know, that goat right there looks an awful lot like my Uncle John.
Quit volunteering my services.
Hey, I was just trying to help.
Well, don't.
Oh, okay, I get it. This is just like back at the clinic, right? Yeah, I'm the cold-hearted, uncaring creature who doesn't give a damn about patients or goats, and you... You are the passion-filled humanitarian who walks with both lions and lambs and doesn't eat meat.
Are you gonna help me with this or not?
All right, so choose.
God.
All right, look. Cover your eyes, spin around 3 times and point. That'll be guilt-free. What? Think of it as one of them winning the lottery, only...
Losing?
Exactly.
What you gotta look for, Ben?
Koplik spots, named after the infamous Dr. Koplik, no doubt. And his wife, Mrs. Koplik. And all the little Koplik kids who may or may not have had Koplik spots.
Koplik spots show up as pale yellow spots on the inner cheek. Sure sign of measles. Got any kids, Ben?
Yeah, me.
Okay, next we check the abdomen for rash. And lastly, you check for rash behind the ears.
Okay, that's it. You're all done.
Please help me! My daughter! She's choking a chicken bone! Oh, help me!
It's not coming out.
Help her, please! Help her,
we gotta get her to the clinic. There's no time. She'll suffocate. Put her on the table!
Ben, what are you doing?
Hold her head back. Shut up. Give me some gauze.
Save her, please.
She's breathing. Now what? Put the gauze, the
base of the pan. Stop the bleeding. Okay. Now, let's get her to the clinic. Now. It's okay. We got you.
The Grand Am's great.
Well, what happened to the Accord?
Yeah.
I found out what the Accord really cost. With air, automatic, anti-lock brakes, $19,500.
Whoa.
Huh? They weren't talking to me.
Really? Wow. The Grand Am, they don't give that away.
Air, automatic, standard anti-lock brakes,
yeah.
5,000 less than the Accord.
Five less?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Do you know what that means a month? Got me into a new car.
What are you gonna do with the money?
Eat. Money, yeah.
To be a pesto, but did you know some grated toppings are 1/3 fats and fillers? Kraft is 100% grated Parmesan for 100% great taste. Mmm, grato.
If she had a fever, you wouldn't wait to see the doctor. So why wait to fix the brakes on the car you drive her around in? When Midas can fix your brakes right the very same day you bring in your car. Midas, because your brakes can't wait.
Matlock helps a happy hooker.
Hi, Benjamin. 25 years into business, and now this.
Solicitation.
And believe me, this is something I'm not going to take lying down.
But the judge is one of her clients. Matlock, Thursday. Then...
This is the guy who unites star-crossed lovers.
And old flames in town.
Oh, I lie.
Once a year is not enough.
She's married.
And love is blooming for Jack.
She never brings her husband? Oh, sorry.
Jack's Place, Thursday.
Going to extremes will continue in a moment.
This little face has captured the hearts of millions. Teachers, neighbors, all saw the warning signs. So why did it take being imprisoned in a dungeon to bring help to the life of 10-year-old Katie Beers? Her story on Primetime Thursday.
On the next live, he's back. All my children's 10. Michael Knight here on the next live.
At 9 on Channel 7.
And begin. Now lift and squeeze. And keep it moving. Now we're cooking. All right. Feels great, doesn't it?
Good evening. I'm Harold Green. Coming up tonight at 11, police search for a bank robbery suspect tonight after a wild pursuit. We'll have exclusive pictures of the dramatic high-speed chase. A doctor is accused of drugging, raping, and murdering a young female patient. A gay couple that wants to get married is promoting family values in the Southland. And President Clinton may delay his decision to lift the ban on gays in the military. All when I get together with Ann at 11.
If you and your checking account could use a change of scene, come on over to Wells Fargo Bank. Enjoy longer hours, 5-minute max teller service, 24-hour person-to-person phone service, and a Wells Fargo Stagecoach check that's a change of scene all by itself. Move all your accounts to Wells Fargo today. The change of scene will do you good. Wells Fargo Bank, a better brand of service.
Rendezvous with Remington Steele, tonight after Nightline on 7.
About our verbal jousting last night, I brought you a peace offering. Hanover, basket of apples.
For solitude, so he can work and rely on his own judgment and his own opinions and avoid the inane and idle mutterings of idiots.
Who the hell are you calling an idiot?
You! You're eavesdropping, you're snooping, you're reading my manuscript.
You got it all wrong.
Yeah, which part?
I was not eavesdropping. I was snooping and reading. What the hell are you gonna do about it?
You know, there's a weasel that lives over on the island's north side that I always watch stealing eggs from unsuspecting birds and turtles, the lecherous bastard.
Are you calling me a lecherous bastard?
And sometimes when he sees me, his eyes bulge out and his ears perk up and he gets all scared and he runs away. But isn't that just like a weasel?
Look, all I did was glance at a couple of crummy pages.
Leave.
It's a free island. I'll leave when I damn well please. By the way, what I read wasn't half bad.
You need mouthwash.
You need certifying.
Tell Dr. Brennan I'll be at the hospital in about an hour.
Dr. Norris, is she going to be okay?
Okay is a relative term. There could be complications from the improvised operation. Mr. Harrison? This procedure you performed on the little girl, walk through it with me.
Well, she was choking on a chicken bone, and I found the soft spot right here below the Adam's apple.
Yes, yes, go on.
And I made an incision about an inch deep and stuck the hollowed-out pen through the skin to start her breathing.
And where did you learn the procedure?
I saw an army medic do it on a guy once.
And the patient?
What about him?
What happened to him?
He died, I think, of other wounds.
You think or you know? A tracheotomy is a dangerous procedure in the best of circumstances. Severe bleeding if you cut an artery, high risk of infection, especially in a dirty operation. Scarring of the vocal cords.
She was choking on a chicken bone. There wasn't exactly time to get her family history.
Well, now there is. Unless you want to risk lockjaw. After the patient is released from the hospital, you will need to go to the girl twice a day. You will administer antibiotics and the tetanus immune globulin prescribed, change her dressings, and meticulously monitor her progress.
Yes, sir.
And I want you to write a full report on an emergency tracheotomy. Alternatives. Why it is performed. Risks of which I named only a few. Recovery and after effects. By tomorrow.
Dr. Norris, he did save her life.
I'm aware of that.
Beth, we need to talk.
Is there some problem with the wedding plans, Colin?
Well, yeah. It's about me being in the ceremony.
Alongside Kathleen.
Exactly. Listen, I don't know. Lately, it's like everything I say is wrong. I mean, I can do no right with her. So maybe it would be best if I didn't, you know, participate.
You think it's you or Kathleen?
My honest opinion? I couldn't tell you.
Colin, you care for Kathleen?
Yeah, I do.
No, I mean, really care for her.
Yeah, I really do.
Then I want you to be in my wedding. It would mean a lot to me.
Beth, I don't know.
So you're giving up on Kathleen, right?
No, I didn't say that.
But you'd rather back out of the wedding.
No, 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 I didn't say that either.
Then you're coming to the wedding, but not because of Kathleen?
Yeah, right.
Good. Well, I'll see you there then. I'm really glad we had this little talk, Colin. I was a little confused for a minute.
Generally speaking, then, the arteries transport oxygenated blood and the veins transport deoxygenated blood. Now, the blood vascular system is, yes, Mr. Harrison, isn't it?
Yes, Dr. Davis, I'm confused. You say arteries carry pure blood, but don't they also carry impure blood to the lungs?
Yes, they do.
Well, how can it go both ways?
Mr. Harrison, have you read up on the chapter concerning arterial functions?
Yes, ma'am, I have.
Mr. Lauren, answer Mr. Harrison's question, please.
Well, Dr. Davis was only talking about the systemic arteries. They carry only oxygenated blood. But pulmonary carries impure blood, as you said, Ben, to the lungs.
Perhaps, Mr. Harrison, you didn't see the footnote at the bottom of the page.
No, ma'am, I didn't.
It refers to the next chapter, which Though not assigned, I expected all of you, due to your natural curiosity, for the bread.
I'm sorry to have interrupted.
Sorry? Well, as the saying goes, Mr. Harrison, there's no such thing as a stupid question. Though yours came quite close. Need your footnotes, sir. Enjoy them. Now, onto the thorax. It's a cavity of great importance to us all, since it contains the heart as well as the lungs.
Starting to come together nicely.
Yeah, it is.
You know, my father wanted to marry my mother in this posture.
But he didn't?
Well, my mother wanted to get married in a church. It caused a big ruckus, you know. They almost didn't get married at all because of that.
Sounds like a familiar argument.
So what happened?
They were fighting and they were fighting. But finally, my grandmother intervened. She told him, you must find the thing that brought you together in the first place. And the decision will make itself. When you two are happy, you know, everybody will be happy for you. You know, I think they took our advice.
So, where did they get married? In the church or the pasture?
They looked. By the way, you know, these tablecloths are upside down. But it looks good.
Good
afternoon.
Grandma.
Hey, Mom, what go on?
Better, that's grand. Come on, come on.
Guys.
Are you the doctor man who opened the girl's throat?
Nope. Wrong guy.
Yes, you are. You're the doctor man.
Nathan, don't say that to him. Ben, if my grandkids bother you, just tell them to go and they'll go away.
Well, they're a pretty rowdy bunch, but I think I can handle them.
Hey, this is one heck of a lamp.
And where'd it come from?
Well, they heard you saved the girl and they wanted to say thanks.
Well, I wish I knew your name so I could thank you properly.
Nathan.
Elizabeth. That boy's too shy. His name is Eddie.
Nathan, Elizabeth, Eddie. Thank you.
Captain Bligh, permission to come aboard.
Suit yourself.
I haven't heard that concerto outside my own head in 9 years. I had the third movement completely wrong. Actually, I think I like mine better.
Hey, Sloop. You take the trades well?
She does all right.
I came here myself on a 42-footer, the Avalon.
And you sunk her?
I wanted to avoid the temptation. That's the one thing that I've lamented not bringing with me, chess set.
Well, single man chess and grade was better than nothing.
I find that I'm a more challenging opponent for myself than most people.
Ever heard of the word conceited?
As in arrogant?
As in full of it, Hanover.
Never. Nice, Jerry Wood.
So, okay, what is it you want? You want a game?
I'm game if you're game.
Don't understand you. Yesterday, you were my judge and jury. Now you're trying to kill me with kindness. What is it with you?
I used to party with Bob Dylan. This was before the born-again thing. I always said that every man had a weakness and that mine was that I didn't know what mine was.
Do you know what Spassky's weakness was in his match with Fisher?
Sure, he didn't understand Fisher's use of the field.
Exactly. Best you to thinking linearly. While Fisher treated the field like a three-dimensional universe.
But while Fisher's playing the first game in front of him, Spassky's setting up the second game in his head.
And are we going to have a second game, Richard?
That all depends.
On what?
Your next move, Professor.
From the moment football began, people have been arguing over facts and statistics. Pick up TV Guide this week and set the record straight on the Super Bowl once and for all. This week in TV Guide. Plus, Coach Craig T. Nelson tells why men fumble with intimacy and can't tackle commitment. Also, get sports highlights, movie reviews, and other features no newspaper listing offers. Only this week, only in TV Guide.
Our wedded bliss could be over. All we have left are two NyQuil liquid caps and these other pills.
You take the liquid caps. You've got a big day tomorrow.
Why should you suffer? I'll take these.
But then you could still be up tonight with a sore throat and a cough, and you need the rest more than me. I insist.
The power of liquid medicine the way you want it. Vicks NyQuil liquid caps. The nighttime sniffling, sneezing, coughing, aching, stuffy head fever so you can rest medicine.
I just hope my coughing doesn't keep you awake, riddled with guilt.
People have switched to AT&T in the last 2 years. And thousands more switch every day. Switch now to AT&T for competitive prices and unsurpassed quality. It's easy to be with the best. Call 1-800-742-3555.
horsepower V6. The feeling it gives you on the open road. The 1993 Toyota Camry.
Taking the long way again?
I'll be home soon. Just unwinding.
Few cars actually move you. This Camry just may be one.
Each day in this world, 5,000 people become infected with HIV, the virus that causes AIDS. Most of these people had unprotected sex or shared a needle with an infected person. Whether you're gay, straight, or bisexual, always protect yourself. Use a condom every time you have sex, every time. And if you inject drugs, don't share the needle. Don't make it 5001.
A lonely young woman.
I guess you think you're going to get another husband and leave. Well, it won't work, not at your age.
Escapes to a secret life.
Isn't it about time I found out something about you?
What are you trying to hide from me, Kate?
Where chance encounters.
What are you doing here alone?
Could be deadly.
Has anybody been looking for me?
And what'd you say his name was?
Annette O'Toole, Kiss of a Killer, Monday.
God created the stars to fill our minds with dreams. And he created the world to fill our hearts with wonder. But nothing so fills our soul as when God brings together two people who we love because of the love between them. Will the best man hand Roger the ring, please? Roger and Beth, the rings you have brought today, their weight and their substance symbolize the love embodied in your heart, mind, and soul. Roger, as you place the ring on Beth's finger, please respond thoughtfully. Will you, Roger Nottage, take Beth to be your lawfully wedded wife?
I will.
Will the maid of honor hand Beth the ring, please? Will you, Beth Walters, take Roger to be your lawfully wedded husband?
I will.
'Tis with pleasure that I pronounce you man and wife. You may kiss the bride.
Yes.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
One for the best man, and one for the maid of honor. Kathleen, what's wrong? Okay, whatever it is, I'm sorry. I won't say another word.
He was so sweet.
Who?
The goat.
Oh, the goat.
It's not the goat either. Instead, I'm 28 years old. I'm breaking my back studying in medical school in a foreign country. And I'm handling it. But I'm not handling it. I don't know what I want, Colin.
How do you mean?
From life. From school. From us.
Oh.
Can I have everybody's attention, please? This has been a very special day for me. And at this time, I would like to propose a toast to the person responsible for bringing this wonderful lady into my life. At this time, I'd like to toast a very good woman, my best man, Kathleen McDermott.
I think this is where you're supposed to say something.
Oh. I first met Roger when he came into the clinic where I work. He had some dirt in his eyes he couldn't see well from working on his farm. After I flushed out his eyes, I think he saw there was something missing from his life. Well, he found that something. And now she can help him keep his eyes clear. To Beth, may she always be smiling.
Duty beckons. So I guess this is goodbye.
That seventh wave beyond the reef would be a real SOB. Your keel hits the wrong way, your whole boat can be ruined.
Hanover, I've been sailing since I was 4 years old. Thought you might enjoy this. It's all right, I've got two more just like it.
Why would anybody have three identical chest sets?
Why not? I'm gonna ask you a question that's none of my business.
Fire away.
You've been alone on this island for 9 years. You've written God knows how many books. Probably pretty damn good. You've got millions stashed away in the States. And apparently you haven't lost your mind. Are you happy?
I thought I was until you showed up.
Okay, I'm out of here.
Hey. I came to this island 9 years ago because, as trite as it sounds, I didn't know who I was. And all it took was 5 minutes with you to wipe away all those years of soul searching.
Now, don't you lay a guilt trip on me.
You don't get it, do you?
Get what?
You hadn't been here 5 minutes before it all came back. My bragging, my ego games, how much money I had earned. I even left my novel there for you to find. You showed me that I still have every despicable competitive instinct that I thought I'd left behind.
You're a human being. Accept it.
I do accept it, and that puts me back at square one. All the serenity, all the inner calm. I'm a fraud. My work here has just started all over again.
Hanover, that's the biggest crock I've ever heard in my life. You revolutionized the computer industry.
Why? To impress someone? Who cares? The point is, you did it. And the human community benefited.
So what's your drift?
What matters is what you do. If I've learned one thing from this adventure, it's that I may not have got any closer to my father, but I'm more than ever grateful to that university across the water. I need it. It revitalizes me. It gives me purpose.
Your problem, Richard, is not the world. It's finding your place in it. And I'm due back in mine.
Pay me a visit sometime.
I'll think about it.
Well, I'm easy to find. Only an island away.
Henry! Before you go, there's something I need to know. Did Pete Rose ever break Ty Cobb's record for most hits?
Rose broke the record in September 85.
You're kidding. Are you kidding?
No. Scout's honor. And then he went to jail.
Jail? What the hell for?
He thought he was bigger than the game. Like I said, just an island away.
Knock, knock. Oh! Hey, Alex. Come on in. You hungry? Got your basic jerk chicken and suds picnic?
I am starving. Hey, let's take it out on the veranda.
Hold it. I know that smell. Dr. Davis has been here.
She just left.
Eternity?
No, she just left a minute ago.
No, I mean she wears Eternity, the perfume.
Oh.
It's your business, Ben. But let me just say this about Dr. Davis.
Save it. I'm not interested in another trip to the dark side.
You were somehow able to resist her?
Yeah. I've been down that road before.
The spiritual side, Rose, from which you emerged alive?
Barely.
So, Ben, what else in life are you interested in? You know, besides saving people and studying all the time.
Yeah.
For me, Elizabeth?
Yeah.
It's beautiful. Thank you.
Bye.
Not much more, Alex. I love children. I like flowers. Trees. I like the sky.
Me too.
You know, I especially like the Jean-Tiquin sky. It's beautiful, isn't it?
All right, they've been married 7,197 seconds.
98. 99, 2 hours even.
Here.
I have a histology exam tomorrow. An anatomy report due Wednesday. A lab report on Thursday.
I am dissecting my cadaver's lymphatic system tomorrow. I have all day rounds at the clinic on Tuesday. And a 2-day microbio take home on Thursday and Friday.
Piece of cake.
Oh, yeah. Got it all under control.
Colin.
Yeah?
I know I've been confused lately.
Well,
We both got a lot to learn. But a lot of things.
If you were a flame, would you rather burn brightly or for a long time?
If I were a flame?
Yeah.
I don't know. You go first.
I always thought I wanted to burn for a long time. You know, live forever, or at least until a ripe old age. But here, on this island, under the sky, at this moment, I'd rather burn brightly. What about you?
I want to burn brightly. And for a long time.
There's no hope for us, is there?
Absolutely not. And it's only my will that keeps me alive. I've been licked, washed up for years. And I merely survive because of my pride.
Hello there, I'm Harold Green.
I'm Ann Martin.
In the news tonight, the search intensifies for a bank robbery suspect following a dramatic high-speed chase.
A warning tonight about a popular mineral supplement that could be deadly to young children.
It's a family values campaign with a twist. A gay couple is fighting to get married.
And we'll tell you what happens when two of America's most popular leading ladies get together. Those stories next on Eyewitness News tonight.
Think you're pregnant? First Response has invented their easiest, most accurate pregnancy test. No cup. Just hold the tester in your urine stream. White, you're not pregnant. Pink, you are. First Response. So easy, you can trust the results.
Richard Gere in his most powerful performance. Academy Award winner Jodie Foster in her most passionate role.
Who is this man sitting in my kitchen?
In a sweeping romantic saga of a man.
You are not Jack Summersby, so why do you keep going on pretending that you are?
How do you know?
And the woman who would do anything to save him.
I never loved him the way that I love you.
Summersby, rated PG-13, starts Friday, February 5th at a theater near you.
My doctor said Habitrol.
Habitrol?
It's a nicotine patch.
That's the one.
For information, call 1-800-685-2000.
Habitrol.
Ask your doctor about Habitrol nicotine transdermal system. It's only available by prescription.
You should call your doctor.
The Buick LeSabre. Family Circle Magazine's Domestic Family Car of the Year. LeSabre won by finishing first in important family categories like value, comfort, dealer satisfaction, performance, safety, style. And, of course, dependability. Buick LeSabre, a welcome addition to the American family.
Pornography. Chances are it's how boys first learn about sex. Does it twist the way they see real women?
I'm personally upset by how it affected my sexual development.
What did it teach you to look for?
Large breasts, thin waist.
2020, Friday.
I'm Ted Koppel. Later on Nightline, there are Angels of Mercy and a police force, the thorny mission of U.S. soldiers in Somalia. We'll hear from returning Marines tonight.
This is Nancy Snyderman.
And Charles Gibson. Tomorrow, how viewing violent sports can lead to violence at home.
Plus, TV search for the next Oprah and Chef Wolfgang Puck tomorrow on Good Morning America.
Oh, that package, Martha. We could negotiate a deal at the...
To see why T-Fal Nonstick Resist All Pans cook better longer, you really have to get into one, inside and out. The three layers of durable porcelain enamel, the exclusive heat expansion channels that prevent warping, and the long-lasting honey...
Under the corner and back.
Imagine you have a flat. The spare is also flat. In your trunk, you find a graphite tennis racket, some beef jerky, a roll of duct tape, a can of hairspray, and three waterproof matches. Now, how do you fix your tire? Call!
Auto Club.
Air Touch Cellular. The new name for Pactel.
It's kind of incredible being a mother. Maybe the hardest thing you learn is that when it comes to kids, happen. That's why I like this place so much. A place where doctors and nurses practice the art of medicine without being second-guessed by some insurance company. And maybe that's why I feel like a mother to so many of the kids I operate on.
A 5-year-old girl raped in a school bathroom, the story at 11.